now we come to the next topic, which is quadratic programming. This is another technique, or this is another algorithm under closed hashing or open addressing, right? So first we have considered some keys and we want to insert the keys into the hash table of size 11, right? So over here we have considered the hash function, which is something like h of k comma I is equal to h prime of k plus I square mod m. You have to understand each and individual terms mentioned over here. The h prime of k is the primary hash function. The I value can range from 0 to m minus 1, where m is the size of the hash table, right? The h k comma I is basically the secondary hash function and h prime of k is the primary hash function. What is the difference between primary and secondary hash function? You can go to my previous video lecture, which is linear probing, and you can watch that video and you will understand the difference between primary and secondary hash function. So in the primary hash function and in the secondary hash function, the primary hash function is responsible for first producing the hash value for the key k value. And if that key k value and if the index that is generated for that key k value is already occupied by some other data value previously, so there exists, so a collision occurs. And if a collision occurs, that collision can be resolved using quadratic probing by the use of secondary hash function. This hk comma I is the secondary hash function, and this secondary hash function has a variable I which ranges from 0 to m minus 1. So if I start with 0, then this entire hash function will look similar to that of a primary hash function, because if I put h of k comma 0, then I will get h prime of k plus 0 square mod m. So 0 square is nothing but 0, and if it is added with another number, then h prime k is only going to be returned, or it is the only result that we are going to get. So it's basically h prime of k mod m. Again, if I consider h prime of k is again a division hash function, which basically looks like k mod m, then obviously the index value which is generated out of this primary hash function, if it is i1, and if this i1 location is already occupied by some other data value, we know that a collision has occurred, so this i1 location is basically the one that we are going to substitute over here, right? So after the i1, after we know that there is a collision at location i1, we will increase the value of I to 1. Now when we increase the value of I to 1, then h prime of k plus 1 squared. So that means previously we were actually going sequentially. Now we will jump in the power of 2, right? So the searching has not become sequential. It is basically now jumping in the power of 2. So obviously we know that I1 has to be substituted over here. So this is the next value. If this particular value generates I2, and if we find I2 is also occupied, or I2 is a collision again, there is a collision in I2 as well. So h of k comma t will then be equals to h prime of k plus 2 square mod m. Previously in the linear probing, we were actually moving to the second location, right? The second location with respect to the primary hash function, right? If I1 was the first location that was generated by the primary hash function, then the if a collision has occurred in I1, then we were first examining I1 plus 1th location, then we were examining I1 plus 2 location. But now we are examining first I1, which is a collision, then we are examining I1 plus 1, then we are examining I1 plus 4. We are jumping in the power of 2, right? So this I is jumping in the power of 2. If this location is also occupied by a data value, then again we will jump to I1 plus 9, because this I will be incremented to 3, so I1 plus 9. So the value of I is basically jumping in the power of 2. So obviously the number of locations that we are going to search is greatly reduced, and obviously we are not going to suffer from the problem that is known as primary clustering. Now we come to the quadratic probing example. We take an example where there are different keys that we have to insert into the hash table of size 11. And the hash function that we are going to use is again the division hash function, right? And if there is any collision, we are going to resolve that collision using quadratic probing, right? So we'll start with 31. So with starting with 31, that means h prime of 31 will then be equals to 31 mod 11, which is 9. We have to check whether 9 is empty or not. Yes, 9 is empty. So we are going to insert 31 in 9th index, right? Next, what we do is that we take the next location, which is, we take the next key, which is 19. So h prime of 19 will then be equals to 19 mod 11, which is 8, right? So if it is 8, we see whether 8 is empty or not. Yes, it is. So we place 19 in 8th location, right? So now we move on to the next one, which is 2. So h prime of 2 will then be equals to 2 mod 11, which is again 2. So obviously 2 is empty, so we are going to put 2 in second index location. Now we move on to 13. So 13 means this is 13, this is 13, that means again it is 2. So now the collision has occurred. So if there is a collision, then we have to resolve this collision using quadratic probing. That means we are going to take the help of secondary hash function, which is hki equals to h prime of k plus I square mod n. So this is what a quadratic probing is. So obviously for this we are going to put the value of h of 13,1, because we are not going to start with 0, because if I put I equal to 0, it will be the primary hash function itself. So we are starting with I equal to 1. So if I start I with 1, then this will be 2 plus 1 square mod 11, which is 3, right? So 2 plus 3 is 3, so 3 mod 11 is again 3. We check whether 3 is empty or not. Yes, it is. So if 3 is empty, we are going to put 13 in third memory location, right? So now we move on to the next part. We take the next key element, which is 25, right? Which is 25. So 25 means h prime of 25 will be 25 mod 11, which is 3, right? So if 3 is the location, so 3 is the location means there is a collision. So that means we have to resolve the collision using h of 25,1 equals, then h prime of k is basically 3, so 3 plus 1 square mod 11, which is 3 plus 1, 4, so 4 mod 11 is 4. You have to check whether 4 is empty or not. Yes, it is empty, so we are going to put 25 in 4th index, right? Next we move on to 24. So 24 mod 11, which is 2, right? So if it is 2, then we already know that the second memory location is not empty. So it's a collision. Obviously it's a collision. So we have to resolve collision using quadratic probing. So it is 24,1 equals to h prime of k is 2, 2 plus 1 square mod 11. So 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 mod 11 is 3. Is 3 empty? No, it is not. So we have to increase the value of I. We are going to increase the value of I. So 2 plus 2 square is, this is 4, 4 plus 2 is 6, 6 mod 11 is 6. So we search for 6th location. Yes, we have found a free slot. We are going to insert 24 into 6th memory location, right? Then we jump on to 21. So if I jump to 21, then 21 mod 11 will then be equal to 10. So obviously 10 is empty, so we are going to put 21 in 10th memory location, right? So we move on to the next value, which is 9. So 9 means this is 9, this is 9. So obviously the resultant will be 9. So what is the value? So let's see. So 9 is obviously occupied. So obviously there is a collision. Now we have to resolve the collision. H of 9,1. The previously the h prime of k is 9. So 9 plus 1 square mod 11 equals to 9 plus 1 is 10. So 10 mod 11 is again 10. Right? So if it is 10, then already 10 is occupied, so 10 cannot be used as a free slot. So we have to increase the value of I. We are increasing the value of I to 2. Right? So 9 plus 4 is 13. So 13 means 13 mod 11 is 2. So is 2 empty? No, 2 is not empty. So we have to increase the value of I to 3. So when we have increased the value of I to 3, we get 9 plus 3 square. 9 plus 3 square means 9 plus 9, 18. So 18 mod 11 is 7. So 7 is free, yes it is. So we stop our searching anymore and we insert 9 into this location. In this way, we actually insert the key values using the primary hash function as the division function, and then if there is a collision, we resolve that collision using quadratic probing. We will understand the quadratic probing secondary clustering problem using an example, right? So if I consider the hash table size is 11 and I want to insert 77 in a hash table, right? So obviously the h prime of k will then be equals to 77 mod 11. If I take division as the primary hash function, then the outcome will be 0. So now if I say that 0 is already occupied by some location, that means a collision has occurred, then what are the next slots that are generated using quadratic probing? We'll see that first. See, after 0, the next location that is generated is h of k comma I equals to h prime of k plus I square mod n. This is the value that is generated, right? So obviously h prime of k is 0. So if I increase the value of I to 1, right? If I increase the value of I to 1, then h prime of k is 0. So 0 plus 1 square mod 11, which is basically 1, right? So then after that, if I increase the value of I to 2, this will become 0 plus 2 square mod 11, which is 4, right? If I increase the value of I to 3, it will be 0 plus 3 square mod 11, which is 9, and so on, right? And if I consider in all these locations, there is a collision, right? We are not able to find a free slot. So if at any moment of time, say in fourth location, I got 0 plus 4 square mod 11, which is 0 plus 4 square is 16. So 16 mod 11 is 5, right? So in fifth location, I got a free slot and I inserted the 77 in that location, right? Now, if another element wants to get inserted, and that element is h of 88, right? So if you observe carefully, then h of 88, if I want to insert another key element and the value of the key element is 88, then h prime of 88 will give you 88 mod 11, which is 0, right? So when it generates 0, obviously 0 is already occupied by some data value, so there is a collision. Then what you do is that you follow this process, right? So for 88 also, the values that are generated through quadratic probing are the ones that were already generated for 77. So we are simply wasting our time in moving through those locations which are already previously checked for 77. Right, so for both 77 and 88, since the primary hash function has generated an index value which is equal to 0 in both the cases, so the next free slot numbers which are generated using quadratic probing will also be same. This problem is known as secondary clustering problem. So in this problem, what is happening is that for 77, the secondary clustering, whatever value the quadratic probing is generating for 77, right, are the same values that are being generated for 88 as well, because the 88 primary hash function has generated a value 0 for 88 as well, and the primary hash function has also generated a value 0 for 77 as well. So obviously if both the value is 0 from the primary hash function, then the quadratic probing is also going to generate the same set of values that were generated for 77. That means it has to cross all the four hurdles in order to get to the next location if it is empty, so as to enter 88, or so as to insert 88 into that particular location. Otherwise, it is not possible. So obviously, quadratic probing suffers from a problem which is known as secondary clustering. That means linear probing was suffering from a problem which is known as primary clustering, and quadratic probing is suffering from a problem which is known as secondary clustering. Obviously, this particular traversing will get huge if there are maximum number of locations which are generated from quadratic probing are already being occupied by some data value. So as the cells of the hash table, or as the slots of the hash table keeps on filling up, the secondary clustering problem becomes more and more complex.